Hello, I'm Martin Carroll, the Pro Vice Chancellor Academic here at Charles Darwin University. We're a university of about 23,000 students in courses ranging from Certificate 1 through to a PhD. We're based in Darwin, which is the capital city of the Northern Territory, or NT, in Australia. You could fit Texas, California and New Mexico into the NT, and yet we have a population of just 250,000 people. So to reach people distributed in such a massive area, we've had to be creative. We have campuses throughout the NT and also in places like Sydney and Melbourne. But perhaps most importantly, we've become an intensive user of online learning technologies. We've been partnered with Blackboard for over 10 years, and we now have a sophisticated and integrated suite of learning technologies centered around Blackboard Learn and Blackboard Collaborate. These technologies are used by our students whether they're on campus or off campus. We smile a little bit when we read the literature and the media about MOOCs because it feels as if a number of on-campus universities have suddenly discovered the possibilities that come with online learning. But the idea that a MOOC is freely available and open does open up exciting possibilities for new learning communities, and we're keen to explore that. For our first MOOC, and with the consent of one of his great-great-grandsons, we chose our namesake Charles Darwin, his revolutionary theory on evolutionary biology, and in particular, how it relates to where we are here in tropical Australia. In designing the MOOC, there were seven key things that we wanted to get right. Number one, we wanted this to be a learning journey and not just storytelling. There are plenty of documentaries and books about Charles Darwin and his theory. We wanted this to be about studying what Charles Darwin was all about. Secondly, we wanted it to be interactive. We know deep learning happens when students get to engage and interact with the material and with each other. So we incorporated discussion boards and live webinars. The use of Blackboard's course sites was a good tactical choice because not all MOOC platforms enable that type of functionality. Now, given that synchronous human interaction is not always going to be possible, we also decided to make some of the rich media content interactive. We also decided that the content in our first MOOC would be entirely of our own creation. Now, of course, universities always have and always will draw upon the intellectual property of others to put together a globally relevant course. But for our first MOOC, we wanted to showcase our own research and our own ability to generate high-quality online resources. Fifthly, we decided to bring the wow factor, not at the expense of focusing on the learning taking place, but let's face it, the days of boring talking head videos and PDFs on their own are over. Sixthly, we wanted to assess the student learning taking place. So every module that we used concluded with a quiz and some assessment activities. And lastly, we wanted to see if free and open courses could give prospective students a chance to experience what it would actually be like if they were studying with Charles Darwin University. Given that we are a Blackboard user, Blackboard course sites for our MOOC was not only a good technical choice, it was a good strategic choice. So now that we've had our first MOOC experience, as a university, what have we learned? First of all, we've learned an awful lot about teamwork. To make this MOOC happen, we drew together the academic staff who had the content and assessment expertise. We brought in educational designers and developers, technical experts who knew about how to create the digital learning resources and how to use the MOOC platform. Marketing crew who helped make sure that the world knew that this MOOC was available. What we have learned about that type of teamwork, we will take forward not just in relation to other MOOCs, but more broadly in terms of how we work as a university. We took the decision that our MOOC would include live learner support. We have learned that that is an entirely different proposition in terms of design, in terms of deployment, in terms of resourcing, than the type of MOOC that is always available. It's permanently online. You can come in and out anytime you like, but you won't necessarily have any live learner support. We can see the pros and cons of both, but we have certainly learned that they are two different things. To produce a high quality MOOC does require specific expertise. Being a major online provider, we do expect our academic staff to know how to use Blackboard Learn, to know how to use Collaborate, to know how to create things like voiceover, PowerPoint files that can be uploaded, but to create things like interactive 3D animations, to use Google Maps in interactive ways, this requires specialist skill, and our university has now brought that in. It's probably also true to say that one of the reasons that developing this MOOC was attractive to the academic staff and to the finance staff is that the time and investment that went into creating some of these high quality digital learning resources can also be reused in our credit bearing courses. So people talk about the cost of MOOC. We think our MOOC might have cost $150,000 to make, but the benefits can be embedded in our revenue generating courses as well as in our free MOOC. Look, CDU is not going to make hundreds of MOOCs. We're already an online university. But where we think a MOOC will allow us to reach out to new groups of people and possibly stimulate a little bit of interest in them furthering their formal education, then we'll certainly take a look at those options. We also think that a MOOC is a fantastic way to pursue collaborations with other providers, universities in other countries. A MOOC, after all, being free, being non-credit bearing, is a comparatively low-risk activity to be involved in, but potentially very high impact. What a great way to explore collaborative delivery possibilities with other universities. Enough from me for now. I hope you have a look at the MOOC itself. Enjoy.